Hi, my name is Cooper. I'm a math teacher and a data scientist, and I love to talk about math and statistics. Linear regression. What is it exactly? In this video, we'll take a look at what linear regression is and try to understand it using some examples. Then, we'll go over different ways of using linear regression to find a linear model or a line of best fit given a set of data. Finally, we'll discuss ways to evaluate our model and see just how well a linear relationship describes our data set. What is linear regression? Let's look at an example. I measured the height and the weight of 10 people I work with. Just by looking at the data, you can see that as we move right along the x-axis, the data points appear higher and higher on the graph. This is to say, the taller coworkers tend to weigh more than the shorter coworkers. That makes sense, doesn't it? This data has a positive trend, meaning that as the x value increases, the y value increases as well. We can also conclude by looking at the data, the relationship between height and weight appears to be linear. All this means is that for each unit increase in the x value, the y value goes up by the same amount each time. If the data appears to have a linear relationship, then we can approximate the data with a line, either by drawing it right onto our graph, like this, or by calculating the formula of the line using the individual data points we have. The process of finding this line, known as a linear model, or a line of best fit, is what we mean when we say linear regression. So how do we find the line of best fit for a data set? Well, just like before, one way is to simply plot the data and then manually draw a line through the center of the data. We remember that we can write the equation of any line as y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. By extending our line, we can visually see where it intercepts the y-axis. Then we can find the slope by picking two points on the line and using the slope formula. Now, we just have to plug in our values m and b into our equation for a line, and boom, we have a linear model for our data. We can now use our model to predict how much someone might weigh given their height. In our data set, we don't have a measurement for anyone that is 65 inches tall. We can use our linear model by plugging 65 in for x and then calculating y. Now, even though this method works, there are a few problems. First of all, plotting all the data points by hand is a lot of work, especially if we have a lot of data. Secondly, sometimes it's hard to tell exactly where to draw the line of best fit. Oftentimes we can get close, but it would be nice if we could mathematically define an optimal solution. The most common method for mathematically deriving values for the slope and the y-intercept is called the least squares method. Essentially, what we're trying to do is minimize the total vertical distance between all the points in our data set and the line of best fit that we eventually draw. Luckily for us, there are formulas that allow us to calculate the optimal values for both the slope and the y-intercept that minimize this total vertical distance. They look a little scary, but really, all we have to do is calculate a few things and then combine them according to the formulas. What we'll need is the sum of all the x's and their squares, the sum of all the y's and their squares, and finally, the sum of all the products, x times y. Remember, the funny-looking e thing, that just means sum of. So we just plug in the sums according to the formula, and we get this for the slope, and this for the y-intercept. Compared to the line we drew earlier, we can see that it's pretty close. That means, according to the least squares method, we almost drew the perfect linear model by hand. Go us. Finally, I want to talk about how good our linear model is. While it's true that we already calculated the best possible linear model according to the least squares method, it doesn't mean that the best linear model will even be a good model. The data might just not be very linear, or there might not even be a relationship between the x and y values at all. One way we can measure the goodness of fit of our linear model is with something called the correlation coefficient, often referred to as the R value. This is a number between -1 and 1 that will give us an idea of how well our model matches or predicts our data. The closer it is to 1 or -1, the better our model is. An R value of exactly 1 or exactly -1 means that all of the data points fall exactly on our line. On the other hand, if the R value is closer to 0, it means that the data is not very correlated, and our linear model won't be a reliable predictor of new data. Most of the time, an R value more than 0.6 or 0.7 away from 0 means that you have a pretty good linear correlation. To calculate the R value, we use the same sums that we've already calculated previously and plug them into the following formula. The R value we get for our data is pretty good, so we can be confident that our linear model is a good fit for the data. Be careful though. Sometimes you get an R value that looks really good, but that doesn't necessarily mean a linear model is the best model for the data. Consider the following data set. The R value of the linear model shown here is quite high, but does the data seem to imply a linear relationship? Perhaps some kind of non-linear regression technique would be a better practice in this case. One more thing to remember is that we can use these models to measure correlation, but that does not always imply that one measurement is the cause of the other. There's a famously strong positive correlation between the number of ice cream sales and the number of deaths by drowning every year. Does that mean that to avoid drowning, we should stop buying ice cream? No. It just means that both of these statistics can be explained by something else entirely. More people eat ice cream and swim when it's hot outside. In summary, linear regression refers to the process of finding a linear model or line of best fit to describe a correlation or a relationship between data. We used the least squares method to find the line of best fit, but there are other methods out there as well, even if they are less common. We also saw how to calculate the correlation coefficient in order to measure how well our linear model describes our data set. What are some interesting and surprising correlations you see in your day-to-day life?